Now, let's concentrate our mind on special difficulties. Word building. 那我们把注意力集中在难点上，构词法。那动词后加上后缀 er, ist, ness, ion, ity, 往往可以组成名词。动词后加 er, 如果是以不发音的 e 结尾的，只叫 er, 表示行为的主动者，做某事情的人。For example, work, worker, teach, teacher, murder, murderer, write, writer, read, reader. 那么在名词在动词后加上 ist, 表示某种主义者或某种信仰者，某种从事某种职业的人，或专门从事某种研究的人。For example, copy, 抄写， copyist, 抄写员， copyist, type, 打字， type, 那么去掉 e 加上 ist, typist, 打字员。当然不一定是动词加 ist, 名词其后加 ist, 那么也变成具有同样含义的表达方式。Novel, 小说， novelist, 小说家， drug, 药物， druggist, 药剂师， tobacco, 烟草， tobacconist, 烟草商， tobacconist, tobacconist。在形容词之后加后缀 ness, 使这形容词变成了抽象名词，表这个名词表示一种性质、情况、状态。如果是以 y 结尾的形容词，把 y 改成 i 再加 ness。A kind, kindness, bitter, bitterness, happy, happiness, willing, willingness, 啊，这样的词是数不胜数的。那有些动词后直接加 ion 构成名词，然后 suggest, suggestion, possess, possession, detect, detection, collect, collection。 那以 te 结尾的动词必须把不发音的 e 去掉再加上 ion。 For example, translate, translation, complete, completion, graduate, graduation。 那么某些以 AIM 或 AIN 结尾的动词必须把其中的 I 去掉再加上 ATION。 Explain, explanation, EXPLAIN, explain, 而其名词形式必须把字母 I 去掉， EXPLANATION。这一点同学们一定要细心。 Explanation. For another example, 惊呼， exclaim, E-X-C-L-A-I-M, 那么它的名词形式 exclamation, E-X-C-L-A-M-A-T-I-O-N。 那我们最后要讲的一个后缀 ity, 这个后缀应该加在形容词之后，构成抽象名词，表示性质、状态，以 able 或 ible 结尾的形容词在变成名词的时候，要把 able 变成 ability, A-B-I-L-I-T-Y, 把 ible 变成 I-B-I-L-I-T-Y。 For example, able, ability, probable,probability, possible, 可能的， possibility, movable, mobility。 那么这只不过是一点点的规律，那么词汇主要是还靠大家在平时阅读和听力的过程当中去积累。 Now let's do the exercise at page 52. Supply the missing words in the following sentences. Number one, he studied physics at university. Physics, 物理. He is a physicist. 他是物理学家。P-H-Y-S-I-C-I-S-T. Number two, he works in a mine, 矿井. So he is a miner, M-I-N-E-R, 矿工。Number three, pastor did a great service to what? Human, 人。那么这里显然是为慈善事业。The humanity. H-U-M-A-N-I-T-Y. H-U-M-A-N-I-T-Y. Humanity. Number four, he's trying to make a good impress. 动词给某人印象。那么我们这里需要的是什么呢？名词印象 so impression I-M-P-R-E-S-S-I-O-N 留下了很深的印象 make a good impression Number five His paintings have been admired for their original 你要注意这个 original 初始的原始的那么它的名词形式 originality O-R-I D-I-N-A-L-I-T-Y 一定要注意在 original 之后加出 I-T-Y 注意它的发音 Originality OK, read with me Original Originality Now let's do the exercise in multiple choice questions Number 1 When the Titanic set out from Southampton Of course we choose dog She was sailing on her maiden voyage. On her first voyage, you know, on her maiden voyage. 首航,处女航。Number two. What happened once the iceberg had been spotted? We choose C. The Titanic quickly changed her course in order to avoid the direct collision. Number three. The Titanic sank because she had beenbadly damaged by an iceberg. We know 5 of the 16 watertight compartments had been flooded. And number 4, key structure. We choose boy on board her. Her, 在这里指代的是 the great ship. 那我们再应用在这个飞机上 on board the plane. 在火车上 on board the train. 在轮船上 on board the ship.Number five, no one thought she sick, for she had 16 watertight compartments. 没有人想到她会下沉。那么同学发现表示下沉的可能性，所以我们应该选择第四个选项。No one thought she could possibly sink. Okay, number six, she, 4 days when a huge iceberg was suddenly spotted. 那么有了段时间 full, 所以我们这里应该用过去完成进行时。And she had been sailing for days. Number seven. So faint. So, 用一句首句子必须倒装。So faint had been the noise that no one thought. Number eight. As there were not enough lifeboats. 在原文当中用 not enough, 不够。所以它这里显然的 选项第四个 too few, 太少了。Number nine.The great ship sharply to avoid direct collision. 突然转向 No, change course. 那么我们可以选用 A, weird. Rear means turn. 而 boy 选项 change, 我们要表达为 change course. Number 10. The Titanic turned narrowly missing the immense wall. 勉勉强强躲过了这个巨大的冰川。躲得很及时。Just in time. 那么用以替换原文的 just in time, 我们应该选用 C 选项 with no time to spare. 一点时间都没有浪费，一点时间也没有节省的抽得出来，所以它言外之意强调很及时。而 A 选项 in next to no time, it means at once, immediately, 它表达含义立刻马上。Boy 选项 on a sudden impulse,凭一时的冲动。Number 11. The captain went down to investigate. 那么它的侧重点在于下去调查，去看发生了什么情况。So the captain went down to see what had happened. So we chose boy to investigate. Number 12. There was not enough in the lifeboat for everybody. 没有足够的空间。So we chose a room. 而 C 选项 volume, 容量容积 area, 地区 place, 地方地点。Okay, so much for the exercise in lesson 10.